Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our annual Black History Program. We are tired, but we are thankful that the Lord is using us to be here to do this program tonight. Our staff decided on a theme this year, "To God Be the Glory." I think our days are going to get a little rougher, and sometimes we just have to take a break and say, "To God be the glory." We will face some trials, some tribulations as we have, but tonight, we're not gonna worry about those things. The Bible in Isaiah says that God looked for intercessors, and we are a school that is trying to become those intercessors that God is looking for, which means we're going to pray more. We are going to do the things God would have us to do more because he's so good and because we live in those times. So we want you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the ministry that our children will give us tonight. God bless you.
Bless you. Trouble the water.
dressed in red. God's gonna trouble the water.
Looks like the band that Moses led.
God's gonna trouble the water. Wait in the water. Wait in the water, children. Wait in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. God's gonna trouble the water.
Just follow me down to Jordan Stream.
God's gonna trouble the water. Wait in the water. Wait in the water, children. Wait in the water. God's gonna trouble the water.
Just like thunder.
Somebody's calling my name.
Sounds just like thunder.
Somebody's calling my name.
Sounds just like thunder.
Somebody's calling my name. Oh my Lord, oh my Lord, what shall I do? What shall I do?
Just like Jesus.
Somebody's calling my name.
Sounds just like change. Heal, free, deliver. I found joy, peace, grace, and favor.
mountain my Lord spoke. Out of his mouth came fire and smoke. Looked all around me, it looked so fine. I asked the Lord if all was mine.
Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray.
The Jordan River is chilly and cold. It chills the body, but not the soul.
There ain't but one train upon this track. It runs to heaven and right back.
Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray.
Down in the valley when I feel weak, it's when the devil usually speaks.
Because he's crafty and full of lies, I need the Spirit to keep me wise.
Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray.
I have trials and I have woes and I have heartache here below.
But while God leads me, I'll never fear, for I am sheltered by all his care.
Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Yeah.
freedom.
Oh, freedom.
Oh, freedom.
Oh, freedom.
Oh, freedom.
Oh, freedom.
Over me.
And before I be a slave,
I'll be buried.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. I will sing your praise, for you've done such a marvelous thing. For someone so wretched, yet my soul you have redeemed. No one else could do it. No one could care.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Are you enjoying the program so far? Have you forgot about your trouble so far? To God be the glory, great things He has done. Now, if you're enjoying the program and you want to see more in the future, it's your time to participate by giving. Amen. Do we have some ushers in the house? Brother Wells. All right. We're going to take this time and ask all of our parents to stand. Amen. Thank you, parents. Thank you for entrusting your children in our care. I know we don't always see eye to eye, but that don't matter tonight, right? We enjoy every day what we do with our students. And I want to touch on one thing that I want the record to be clear. And I want you to come and see me, please. With communication, I know some of you are saying you're not getting any information. Here is our process of what is happening. We are generating letters, newsletters, and we are giving them to the teachers to tell the students to put them in their book bags. So because we're doing that method, we are asking that you look in their book bag. You should check your child's book bag every night. Every night. We are also out front trying to give the letters to the parents. Sometimes it's not you picking up the child, but we don't want to give the information and it not getting your hands. If those first two fail, we're asking that you stop by the office and have a conversation. Hey, what's going on? I don't know what's going on. Okay, because we have a lot of people asking other people other than the people in the office. So please, we're willing to work with you to get the information to you, but you have to talk to us in the office, and we want to make sure that you do know the wonderful things that are happening. Let us bow our heads for the offering that is about to be lifted. Heavenly Father, we pray your blessing on the offering that we're about to receive. May it be used to further your ministry through these young people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We also would like to remind you, Mrs. Fulmore, where are you, Sister Fulmore? Okay, Sister Fulmore has the scholarship checks that came in yesterday. So if you would, please see her before you leave so that we can continue paying salaries. Some people say, I love money. Everybody loves money, okay? I don't get an extra dime of this money, but it goes to paying our staff and helping our students to be a part of some of the programs that we have presented. We have some other guests in the house that I'd like to introduce at this time. We have Mr. Robinson in the back. Mr. Artie Robinson, would you please stand? Mr. Robinson was here for our Christmas program, and as you know, if you don't remember, he is our architectural engineering teacher, and he teaches our students via Skype free of charge. Thank you, Mr. Robinson, for your sacrifice. At our Education Day program, the students will show you what our school expanded should look like because they are generating it through the CAD engineering class. Amen? So we are going to put those blueprints, plans in the hands of our boards, our architect, whomever the church may choose, so that you can see we need a new facility because we are growing by leaps and bounds. To God be the glory. We also have Ms. Heather Barbuto. Ms. Barbuto, would you please stand? Ms. Barbuto is our Title I teacher, and she does not get enough credit for the things that she do. Title I services are no longer just for people who we consider slow. Some people say that, but the ministry that she brings to our students at Doja, they are just showing out, okay? Their reading has far surpassed. We have even had to graduate some out because their reading scores went up so much. Amen. Thank you, Ms. Barbuto, for your work. We also want to mention our evaluation. This week, we had 2 days of visitors who came in and examined, as I call, from the rooter to the tutor. Okay? Every part of the building, every program, every classroom was examined. The results are wonderful. There were 7 major commendations that they said no other school is doing in this conference. Now, that being said, we still have work to do. We were at a teacher's in-service last Sunday, and another teacher from another school said, Doja never sits down. And we can't, because we have to continue to bring the best for our African-American children. Amen? The Bible says we are the head and not the tail. We are above and not beneath. And as long as I have breath in my body, I will fight for these little ones till the day I die. That is what ministry is about. Okay, I know we have the offering here. Let's do the prayer over the offering.
Let us pray. Loving Lord, we thank you for this wonderful school, staff, and all that you've given us. Continue to bless them and bless the givers who give freely to them. Bless the funds that will go to help our children. And when the saints go marching in, they all will be in that number. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you for your giving. Elder Times, can you raise your hand, please, to take the offering? Thank you. Okay, we're coming to the end of our program, and we have been busy in the community doing some things. Real quick, those who went to the Microsoft store, would you please stand? These 10 students were selected by KOP Mentoring Group to sing the national anthem to some Kenyan children and executives last week at the Microsoft store in Boca Raton. And it was such an amazing experience. These 10 young people made history because no other school has done this. And the community chose the students from our school to sing to them. That deserves a hand. As a result, we also made a connection with Microsoft. We also made a connection with Microsoft, which means they are going to come to our school and they are going to provide. And I will tell you the question they asked me, do you need computers? So parents, those who have purchased tablets, take them home, because what God is about to bring in for every one of our children, we are going to make sure that they have it. Now, your prayers are needed. Your prayers are needed, because when the Lord blesses us, we have to be appreciative, and we also have to give back in return. And we always let them know we are available to minister wherever the Lord would send us. Okay, so we have some wonderful things coming down the pipe. This past Christmas holiday, I had the opportunity of meeting a young lady from the Spady Museum. And there is so much rich history in this city that it takes a while to make my rounds. And so we finally got a connection through our school treasurer, Ms. Gracelyn Stewart. She connected me with Ms. Charlene Farrington at the Spady Museum. And Ms. Farrington put me in connection with Ms. Tanya Akins. Ms. Akins, would you please come forward? Mrs. Akins has brought light to our after-school program. And Mrs. Akins, I want to publicly thank you because every year I've said to the parents, we're going to do this, we're going to do that. Well, now she's bringing these things to our school, to our students after school, and we have groups of things going on. I'm going to let her talk about it and also about the display that they brought. Sister Davis, don't go far. You're next.
Good evening, parents and children. As Principal McCoy said, my name is Ms. Akins, Tanya Akins. I do work at the Spady Museum. I've brought several programs to the school in connection with Principal McCoy. There's going to be more programs. Right now, we have three. We have quilting on Tuesdays from 3 to 5. We also have on Wednesdays gardening. The children go to the Swinton Garden. The Swinton Community Garden on Swinton, right between Docks and the CRA. They go from 3:30 to 4:30. They have a whole hour of playing in the dirt. I'm not going to say playing in the dirt, but digging in the dirt, planting seeds. The Spady Museum actually sponsored a box, a raised bed for the children to plant in. They just did that last week. So they can go over there at any time and work in the garden, as long as they're supervised, obviously. The best day would probably be Saturdays, because there are a number of people that work over there. Also, on Fridays, we have an art history teacher that comes in, and he teaches from 2:30 to 4. So it's a bunch of different programs, and we're going to expand it even more. So just be on the lookout for permission slips coming through the pipeline. And I will go over to the exhibit here. This is the Dr. Carter G. Woodson exhibit. This is also at the museum. It's a movable exhibit. This is the father of Black history. Black history was only a week back in the day. Now it is a whole month. Obviously, they chose the shortest month of the year to give it to us, but we'll take that. If you want to learn more about this exhibit, come see us at the museum. It's up year-round. We just changed into, from our regular Spady exhibit, we have the National Doctors, all Black doctors, exhibited over in the museum now. That will be running until the month of May. So come see us. We're right around the corner. Okay? Thank you.
Brother Dixon, there is a YouTube video for Spady Museum. Could you run that, please?
Think of the worst things people can say about your culture, about your race, about your religion, about your people. Are they true? Could it be that you're not as smart, or you're money hungry, or you're a drunk, or you're cold and calculating? Of course not. You're an individual. Chances are your culture has made contributions in a masterful way to cultures throughout the world. But the more the bigots say it, the more it seems true. The more these stereotypes are hoisted upon the cultural landscape, the more people look at blacks and Jews, Muslims, Catholics, Native Americans, Asians, and Hispanics with wary eyes, wondering if the demonizing insults are true. How in the world can you believe in yourself if those around you believe you're a lesser life form? Dr. Carter G. Woodson had an answer for that. That answer is knowledge.
What, you may ask, is so important about studying history? The answer is as simple as it is important. If you knew your culture's history was directly linked to great writers, powerful leaders, successful business people and pioneers, wouldn't that make you proud? Wouldn't that inspire you to do great things yourself? Those who endeavor to understand their own history are paving a path toward a bright future. Carter G. Woodson, the father of black history, knew that knowledge of the African-American experience would be the last way to destroy the chains of slavery. And so he made it his life's passion. In early 20th century America, it was popularly accepted that blacks in Africa had contributed nothing to world civilization, that slavery actually benefited those Africans who had the good fortune to be caught up in the slave trades.
It was damaging African Americans because they too were being exposed to these ideas and accepted them as truth. And it had a damaging effect on their self-esteem and their belief in their themselves to be able to go on and educate and contribute to the world.
Those kinds of distortions not only permeated the world of white Americans, but sunk deeply into the souls of African Americans. If one was to believe these lies about his own people, then how could he achieve the confidence to break the mold? In 19 books and dozens of published articles, Carter G. Woodson worked to erase that false history and began to help all Americans of all cultures to understand the true history of the African people's experience in America and across the world.
When you think of black people as inferior, it would only make sense, this argument that they had done nothing to contribute to the world. So he's going to point out all of those fallacies and really try to give the black community a rallying point around which to push their efforts, that we really needed to do something to make people aware, not just black people, but white people, about all of the contributions that people of African descent, both on the continent of Africa and also in this country, have made to the world and to the United States of America.
He believed that hard facts through research and fair-mindedness would bring balance to history, and that his thesis was that all peoples in the world had made a contribution to civilization. And once that people on a mass scale understood this, there would be greater respect for all races, all ethnic groups, all religions.
Before Carter Woodson began publishing his own writings and those of contemporary historians, there were few media outlets that would shed light on the full story of African and African-American achievements in the United States. He made sure Americans heard a different side of the story. In 1926, Woodson founded Negro History Week, which later evolved into Black History Month. To this day, the occasion continues to remind all Americans of the great accomplishments of writers, entrepreneurs, civil rights leaders, artists, and educators who helped create modern America. Woodson also founded what is now called the Study of African American Life and History, founded in 1915. This is the agency that decides on the theme for Black History Month each year. This legacy is still helping to inspire new generations of young people with true stories of outstanding achievements by Americans of African descent.
No person can imagine where he's going unless he knows where he's been.
the more I learn as I've continued to educate myself and to study about people like James Lafayette, like Anthony Johnson, like Maggie Walker, it's an absolute inspiration to me. Because not only did they look like me, but because here you have an individual with enough character, enough strength, enough skill, that living in some very difficult times, they were able to use what they had. No excuses, no pity parties, but use what they had to advance their cause and take not only themselves, but other people to another level.
Across our country today, African Americans have overcome terrible lies and stereotypes to achieve great success. Carter Woodson inspired each of these people to understand the success that has been achieved by pioneers of their culture and the contributions they have made and are now making to our nation.
Thank you, Mrs. Akins, for that presentation. And there is a flyer that, did you bring any flyers? Okay, we will make sure that you get some flyers of some of the upcoming events at the Spady Museum. How many of you have looked in the foyer, saw the decorations, and up here, how beautiful they are? If you think they are beautiful, just give a round of applause. I wish I could take credit, but Mrs. Frances Albury Davis, would you please stand and come forward, and your crew, I don't know who they were, but please, that's you. I know Mr. Davis didn't have a choice, he had to help. So come on up too, Mr. Davis. While they're coming up, let me just let you know, Mr. Davis is very busy with a beautiful garden. If some of you have seen on Facebook, I've put some pictures up of that developing garden because we have funds, grant funds, for him to maintain that garden. And we have been eating. Students, have you been eating? So Mr. Davis has been taking some things to the classroom as well. Come on up, Sister Davis. And I would like for you to tell them the mindset behind everything you did. And thank you so much for a beautiful decoration.
I got called out, so Kiki Hannah, don't leave me up here by myself. Latoya Hannah, where are you? Sonia Collins, Maranatha. Y'all hurry up, the people ready to go home, come. I don't see Maranatha McBean. She coming? She's not here. Latoya? Okay, Latoya's in the back getting ready for the next event tonight. Did you come on?
Oh, I forgot.
No one man is an island. It always takes a team. Somebody labeled me as being, what your husband called me? The head honcho or something. But I was like, your wife is the one with the gift and the talent. But I thought what we tried to bring when asked to do the decoration is Black history. But to us, Black history is not only what has happened in the past, but it's what's to come. And here at Daughter Zion Junior Academy, you're looking at Black history in the bloom. So we lift up our children because God has blessed us with these children at that school, and we know that he has great things for them to do in this world because he told us to occupy until he come. So we must train our children, and they're getting a training. And each one of you are so very special in God's eyes and our eyes. And you too can be the president of the United States of America. And don't let anybody tell you that you can't. And we just say thank you. We also included because we want to be educated about our faith and our work. And there's some very special Black Adventist people. So we have Adventist First out there. And here along the wall, just take time and thank God for all that he has given to us as a people. Thank you. Okay, one more presentation, and this is such good news before our grand finale. We're going to ask our Palm Beach State College representatives to make that presentation. If you ladies would come forward at this time.
Good evening. I just want to say a quick hello, and what a blessing it has been to be here with you guys this evening. My name is Deborah Gordon-Onsim. I'm the Educational and Business Development Specialist at Palm Beach State College. And I just want to tell you, you're doing wonderful things here at the Academy, and may God continue to bless you all.
Good evening, family.
Oh, I love it. You all are so beautiful, absolutely beautiful. I just want to tell you that, first of all, it is so good to be back home, here with my family, being on the road. God has done some amazing things recently, and I don't know why he chose me. I keep asking, but at the same token, I'm just going to keep on moving in Jesus' name. So I am here this evening as the Chief Academic Officer of Palm Beach State College on the Boca Raton campus to present a fantastic award, a Dell computer, to one of these amazing angels that's sitting on this pew in the front. Are you all ready? So we had three finalists, okay? They wrote beautiful essays as to why this computer would be a blessing to them and their families. We had a submission by Patrick Guerrero. Did I pronounce it right? That's one. One of our finalists. Yes, one. That's your son. That's right. Miss Cassie Belazaire, a finalist as well. All right. So it just would be all in the family. And then we had a beautiful submission by Esther Hyacinth. Where's Esther? Yes, that's your baby. So now, this was very difficult because the entire essay, but our top two finalists ended up being Cassie Belazaire and Esther Hyacinth. So now, Cassie, I won't read the entire essay, but I want to share with you. Cassie said, I really hope I have a good chance of winning. Another reason that I want this desktop is for research, programming, and designing buildings. For I am in the robotics programming and architecture engineering class. I could also use it for homework and online assignments assigned by our teacher. Also, so that I can practice programming and designing buildings and also learn how to type. She's also very interested in gaming. So that was Miss Cassie. She has big things on her horizon, clearly. Well, Miss Esther said that she would like to use the computer to help her brother with his assignments. She said that it would be fantastic to have this computer. And she says, watch this, Principal McCoy. She wants to be able to tell her family she did her best, and she will tell her mom that my best principal said that I can do things right. But I will tell you, tonight we are going to award one computer. But we are working on multiple computers, because we really want everybody to be a winner. This computer was donated by United Corporation of America through Mr. Steve King. Let's give him a round of applause. But because this young lady said, I am an overcomer, even if I lose or win, I am happy no matter what. The winner is Esther Hyacinth. Miss Esther. Congratulations. Congratulations to Esther and her family. We know that you are going to use this computer to do amazing things, right? And we're going to help you with that. But what we would like to do is let's give all of our submissions a round of applause, because they did an amazing job. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And again, congratulations to Esther. All three submissions were from fifth graders. Now, our grand finale, Sister Bucard, the music guru, will lead our illustrious staff in our finale song. And before she comes, Miss Barbuto, would you please stand again? Miss Barbuto has a table set up in the back for the parents to come and get some information. If your child is in Title I, please do not leave tonight without seeing her. Let's show some love, parents, because she works just as hard as the rest of us. Please stop by her booth. We are the biggest and the best school in Palm Beach County with Title I services. And Ms. Barbuto is asked at the meeting by her supervisor, how do you do it? She services 74 children every single day by herself. So please do not let her work go to naught. Okay, is Ms. Bucard out of the bathroom? There she is. Please give Sister Bucard a hand. Parents, please remember to stop by the Title I table. Thank you.